Yes, you heard it right.
Every
Monday,
Tuesday,
Wednesday,
Thursday,
Friday. Let's beat the drum.
नमस्कार,
नमस्ते,
नमस्कार,
वणक्कम,
खुशामदीद,
सलामुअलैकुम,
सत श्री अकाल,
इकंदर की वंदनमु,
जय स्वामी नारायण,
जय श्री कृष्ण,
जय जिनेन्द्र,
हमारे इस्माइली भाई बंधुओं को बोल दे याली मदद,
मलाली मदद बोलते हुए सारे फिजी मंदिर को बोलेंगे ईसा बोला बंट जन हम आ गए हैं आपके प्यारे महिमा के द्वारे मैं फालतू बाबा
एंड ऑफ कोर्स माय सेल्फ फालतू रानी लेकर आपके लिए और ड्राइव टाइम दैट्स गोना मेक इट टोटली एक्साइटिंग एंड टोटली डोली मस्तानी
आज का शो है ब्रजन टाइमलेस ट्यूजडेज जहाँ पे वी एक्चुअली गोना टॉक अबाउट हाउ यू नो व्हाट एक्चुअली मेक समथिंग टाइमलेस. देखो हमारे यहाँ पे इंडियन सिनेमा में ना इंडियन सिनेमा का ऑलमोस्ट हजार एक सौ साल हो गया ब्रजन. दैट्स राइट ब्रजन, 100 इयर्स हैव पास्ड. इट्स ऑलमोस्ट 108 इयर्स और 107 इयर्स चल रहे हैं अभी एक्चुअली of Indian cinema, right? And we have actually come a long way from the Balika Badu to the point of, you know, Harishchandra to the point of, you know, where we started off with, right? Rama and everything, Mahabharata, all those narrations to right now we have movies like War.
Oh my God.
We have movies like War, we have movies like Badar, we have movies like, you know, Darna Mana Hai, all those things. We come a long way, right? But we also know the fact that, you know, time for us is very relative. Indian culture, correct?
Okay.
And I think what's happened to us, we have, because we have like 100 years of cinema, right? We also have some movies, so some stories, some songs, which actually have been timeless.
Right.
Mm-hmm. When you say timeless, you know, for instance, Kishore Kumar songs.
Uh-huh.
Even now people hum around.
Right, Mohammad Rafi songs also.
Mohammad Rafi songs.
Yeah.
Yes, even for, see, they all actually, you know, they left us almost like, you know, 40 years ago.
Right.
But we still love them. We still have them in our memories. All the stuff, right?
Right.
So my question today, what our show is going to be about, whether we still have that particular timelessness in us or no.
मतलब
क्या है कि वाल्तोनी वी नो दैट दे हैव बीन इन इंडस्ट्री फॉर क्वाइट सम टाइम. देखो किशोर कुमार साहब ही केम इन इंडस्ट्री 1950s सपोज.
Okay.
50 से लेके 80s तक करो उन्होंने सही में ही हैड लॉट ऑफ इंपैक्ट ऑन द इंडस्ट्री. वैसे देखा जाए तो हमारे आज के जमाने में भी ना वी हैव सम वेरी वेरी प्रोमिनेंट फिगर्स इन बॉलीवुड हु बीन इन इंडस्ट्री फॉर ऑलमोस्ट 30-40 इयर्स.
Okay.
Like for instance, Amitabh Bachchan saab. Amitabh Bachchan saab came in 70s, right? 60s, 70s mein aaye the, right?
Huh.
70s, like, sub 70s pakad lo. 70s mein abhi tak he's still there in the industry.
Huh.
Right? He's got a very huge impact in the industry.
Huh.
Dilip Kumar saab.
Huh.
One of the early heroes of Indian cinema.
Right.
First, one of the first few first Indian movie. I think unka first film, I don't know, 40s mein aaya tha, 1940s mein aaya tha?
Mm-hmm.
Sometime time. Now, even now, he, God bless him, he's with us, right?
Hmm.
But he also is going to be timeless.
Huh.
We still remember Dilip Kumar Saab's acting in that movie, Saleem and Anarkali, where he's not the main character anyways.
Hmm.
But we know, he's timeless.
Huh.
Right?
Huh.
Aisa hamare yahan pe aaj ke zamane mein kaun hai?
Huh.
Who do you think has that stickativity in them to be a timeless personality or timeless music or timeless creation, right?
Huh.
Because, see, being in the industry for almost, being as an industry for 105 years, 106 years, right?
Huh.
That's one big thing already, right?
Huh, huh.
But having to churn out every year hundreds of movies,
huh.
You can imagine how much of a crowd is going to be there.
Huh.
Right now, at one point in time, 2009, we told you, shared some data with you, right? Where Indian cinema was so prolific,
huh.
They actually overtook Hollywood also,
huh.
With the number of movies released. In 2009, suppose they had a record release of around 1,200 movies.
Huh.
Highest ever they released movies, right?
Okay.
But again, it's not the question that every year is going to be the same thing. On an average, we would churn out at least some 500 movies supposed to release.
Okay.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Some big budget, some small budget, some no budget also.
Huh.
But the point is, they are churning out movies, right? Every year we used to have done only COVID time, maybe in spite of the COVID situation, we had releases also, correct?
Mm-hmm.
We still have releases coming up as well, but of course, they have to work very mindfully and everything. But my point is, how many of this is going to be like, you know, long lasting?
राइट
क्या हम लोग 50 साल के बाद सोचेंगे हाँ एक फिल्म आई थी जिसमें एक बंदा था जो लिपस्टिक पहन के नाचा था टाइगर श्रॉफ की बात करता मैं
मुझे मालूम है हमेशा उसकी क्यों लेता है अल्तू बाबा केस और
उसकी क्यों लेता है मतलब क्या था ओह माय गॉड.
Okay.
And well, actually, what I'm asking is, Falthrani, see, aaj ke zamane, let's talk about एक जमाना टाइमलेस सॉन्ग था, विल प्ले सम टाइमलेस सॉन्ग व्हिच यू थिंक इज टाइमलेस, राइट? बट आज के जमाने में कोई टाइमलेस सॉन्ग है क्या? कैन वी प्रेडिक्ट राइट नाउ व्हाट इज गोना बी हियर इन द माइंड्स ऑफ पीपल, यू नो, फॉर द नेक्स्ट 50 इयर्स? कैन यू प्रेडिक्ट दैट? आई डोंट नो, कैन वी फल्तरानी? आई एम आस्किंग यू अ क्वेश्चन, बंदूस, कैन यू प्रेडिक्ट? कैन यू से हाँ इसमें दम था? लाइक फॉर इंस्टेंस, वी स्टार्टेड ऑफ रेडियो ऑलमोस्ट 2009 में, राइट? 2009 में हमने बताया था कि there are some songs which actually released in the millennium,
huh,
which actually have stickability,
right,
which actually,
true,
are going to be timeless,
huh,
and incidentally, so they are still quite in people's mind,
mm-hmm,
right? We'll talk about those, right? Now, आज के ज़माने में, what do you think is going to be something is going to stay up in time, life, right?
Huh.
20-30 years ke baad, people are still going to remember those things,
huh,
because I'm sure people will not forget Amitabh Bachchan. They might forget Salman Khan eventually, but I don't know.
We don't know, right?
There might be some deals who comes to like Salman Khan and become replaced. More, his industry people already have forgotten him because now he's replacing himself with Tiger Shroff.
Huh.
But his industry is no longer going to be timeless.
Uh-huh.
Uska zaman chala gaya.
That, what? No, that's not true, Altu Baba.
Yeah.
Why would you say that? That's just because I like... never mind. It's not that I particularly like Hrithik Roshan. I think he's okay. He's not like that great or anything. But
what? Now he's not a greater because
he's
Tiger
Shroff. He's okay.
Yeah. Well, the point is, how many of us right now actually can recognize something which is going to be timeless? Now, here's a chance for you guys to give us a call on 408-912-2479. And you got to share with us, what do you think is going to be timeless?
Huh.
In the current scenario.
Huh.
आज के जमाने में या यू नो इवन इफ इट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर डिकेड 2010 टू 2020 ओ लेते चलो राइट वी गिव यू अ 10 इयर्स हेड्स अप राइट व्हाट डू यू थिंक इज गोना बी स्टिकिंग विद आवर ऑडियंस फॉर नेक्स्ट 30 और 40 इयर्स 50 इयर्स राइट ओके फाइन यू नो व्हाट 10 इयर्स हाउ अबाउट नेक्स्ट 10 इयर्स विल कम बैक टू द सेम काइंड ऑफ अ शो फादरानी
वेल यू नो अल्तु बाबा Yeah, Insha Ganesh, Inshallah, and with the love of all our bandhus and all your support, definitely, Bandhujan, why not?
Main puchta tha, Faltwani, ki, is that something which you think people will know about?
Maybe not.
Uh-huh.
You know, some of our bandhus may think like, oh, a lot of them may not even know. Aajkal ke gaane hum nahi sunte hain. Hum sirf wo wale gaane sunte hain.
Haan, to theek hai. To wo wale gaane, to that's what exactly we're talking about. We're trying to ask you whether those kind of songs is what, if you match that song with aajkal ke zamane, will any song have stickability? Like, there's one song which I will always say, Faltumni, is going to be there for next 100 years. Not 100 years. At least next 50 years, it'll just definitely going to be in people's minds.
Huh.
You know what song it is?
What?
It is not an old song. It's a millennium song.
Wow.
Yeah.
So, all the Ghanas that we're going to play today now, Altu, they're all going to be millennium songs, right?
Millennium songs.
Meanings, I'm saying. God. Songs that have come out in the since 2000.
Yeah.
The
and they still have stayed famous.
And they have stayed famous over, I mean, dekhiye, 2020 ho gaya, 20 saal ho gaye. I mean, for those of you who want some kind of a time check on it, it's like, you know, how many years since Dil Chahta Hai came out, Altu Baba?
20 years.
20 years of Dil Chahta Hai, Bandhujan. 20 years, right? So, some of these songs have stayed timeless. So, this is our first pick. We feel that this song, even today, can put a dance in anybody's step and will continue to stay on.
And it's actually going to be an anthem for all youngsters. Yeah? Socho.
अपने दिलों का तराना बिगड़ने भी दो झगड़े दुनिया झगड़ने भी दो लड़े जो दुनिया लड़ने भी दो हम अपनी धुन में गाओ टूटने तो कोई छूटे छूटने तो ना घबराओ हम है नए अंदाज क्यों हो पुराना हम लोग अंदाज क्यों हो पुराना सा
आपको कोई गाना या मूवी याद आ गया जो लगता है टाइमलेस रहेगा तो कॉल कीजिएगा। आज हम लोग सब रिकॉर्ड करने वाले हैं, भजन टाइम कैप्सूल में डालने वाले हैं। आज है टाइमलेस ट्यूसडे,
कॉल करना भजन।
Some people actually posted on Facebook right now, but they're asking us timeless, but I thought you're going to be playing timeless old songs. No.
Old songs, though, they've stood the test of time.
Now it's all about predicting the future.
Exactly.
Going by the data you accumulate from the past of all the songs which have been successful, applying that data onto new songs, new presentations, and finding out if these songs actually are going to be something which will stand the test of time, making them timeless, right?
You sound like one of those things from the Grinch.
Yes, it's Christmas. Well, actually, I'll tell you what. Ye gana jo hai na, ye film bhi hai, very unique film tha.
Huh.
Right? And again, it's a path-breaking kind of movie.
Right.
And obviously, it's got to start. It is so far, 20 years down the line, right?
Huh.
People still love this movie. I love the movie still.
Oh, right? Wow.
Yeah. Wow. I don't mind watching the movie again. Matlab, dekho, like, for instance, Sholay is a movie I will watch again and again and again and again and again.
Huh.
That's because I got nothing else to do. A different issue. Wow. The point is, this movie I'll watch for sure.
Okay.
Now, according to you, Falzwani, do you want to give a definition of timeless?
Do I want to give a definition of timeless?
The question is, she'll repeat the question again.
Oh, do I want to give it? You've given the definition. Why should I give another definition of timeless?
So what do you think, Falzwani?
We would love to hear from you, Bandhujan, because what we are saying is timeless is the ganas that kind of, even today, we can sing and dance to.
Mm-hmm.
This particular song that you just heard, Koi Kahe, that particular song, we came out in 2000, right?
Yeah.
1999, 2000, right at the cusp of the millennium.
Yeah.
And even today, you can dance to the song. You can actually sing the lyrics of the song.
Yeah.
And, you know, you can enjoy the particular song, even today.
Yeah.
So this song, clearly becomes classified as a classic. Timeless Gaana, timeless classic.
It'll become a classic. That was 50 years down the line, or 75 years down the line, we'll make it, or 30 years down the line.
Yeah.
This will become 50 years in the song released.
Correct.
People are still going to be listening to the song and jiving and dancing to the song. All discos will play it for sure.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
Because that's what is the definition of timeless, right?
Correct.
It'll be applicable to all the, you know, people in different time zones.
Right.
Like, Deepa rightly posted on Facebook, old songs. Old songs are still timeless because it applies to us even now.
Huh.
Romantic songs, wo bhi tha na?
Huh.
All those kind of songs, we still reminisce those songs, listen to them.
Huh.
We go Google them, or we actually have cassettes, we have tapes, or we have MP3s of all those wonderful songs.
Right.
Right? Some of us are lucky to have the LPs of the songs as well. Right?
Right.
And we listen to them.
Right.
That makes them timeless. They're there in our memory, they're going to be with us until the day we die. Right.
Huh.
And also, what's happened is, many of us, Fazwani, we were not born...
Huh.
When these songs, the old time classics,
exactly, some
came
of
out.
Yes, and even when the songs were like total hits, right?
Yeah.
Like how today, you know, some of us were born and obviously we were in existence when Dil Chahta came out.
Correct.
And even today, we sing and we dance to it because it's considered this is still the song is alive even today.
Yeah, but there are some kids who are born like, you know, 2010 or 20 in the millennium, right?
Hmm.
But they have heard the song from their parents, so it's transferred through... culture as well, right?
Huh.
Ages, transfer to ages. So, aisa bhi ho sakta hai.
Huh.
That also is one way a song can live beyond its time,
okay,
right?
Okay.
Now, what we are saying is, aaj ke zamane mein, do we have the kind of songs?
Right.
We are identifying it, Brijan. Haan, aapko bhi opinion hai, bhai, aaltu faltu ke show pe sabhi logon ka opinion hota hai. Aap bhi aaphe call karo, batao ye particular song, aaltu baba faltu nahi, I think is timeless. Hum laga denge na, aap list mein, yaar, after 10 years, we'll again go back and check it again.
Right.
Right? Mm-hmm. And who knows, we might actually give credit to you that you actually called it first. Right?
Exactly, Brijan. So, aapko yaabhe call karna hai, 408-912-2479 pe. Come on. I mean, you know, there are so many songs. Is millennium mein kitte sare movies aaye, kitte sare gaane aaye, you know, which are still going strong as of today. Aapko call karna hai aur hame batana hai. Kuch aise gaane hain, bahut khoobsurat gaane, lekin they haven't been played. They haven't received a lot of airplay.
Mm-hmm.
So it's time for you to pick up the phone and give us a call and tell us ki what song do you think will last the test of time?
Yeah.
And which people would still dance to?
Mm-hmm.
Would still sing along, would still hum with fondness.
Yeah.
Not like, ye kya bakwas gaana hai.
No. You know, Faldwani, I'll tell you what. I present a song to you who is 20 years old.
Right.
And I'm going to see it's never going to get old at all. Dil Chahta is not going to get old.
That's true.
Because it's music is contemporary.
Mm-hmm.
It looks futuristic.
Correct.
Right? Similarly, there's one more song which I have want to present. But before that, I'll present to you, Faldwani.
Huh.
A caller. नमस्कार आपका हर स्वाद पैम पैम के टाइमलेस ट्यूजडे में हूँ दिस हेलो
पैम पैम
पैम पैम कैसे सर
बस बढ़िया है कल तो इंतजार ही करते रहे
इंतजार इंतजार इंतजार
हमसे प्यार इतना लंबा इंतजार आज तो
हाँ हाँ चलेगा
फिर मैं उसको देख रहा हूँ कि आप बोले जा रहे हो कि अरे दीपा बोल रही है ये और ये बोल रही है फेसबुक में आप फेसबुक देख रहा हूँ कि क्या हो गया मेरा फेसबुक खराब हो गया क्या मेरा तो फीड नहीं आ रहा
होता बड़ा बड़ा शर्म है ऐसी छोटी छोटी बात होती रहती है लेकिन देखो अच्छा बना
पिछले जो जिस टाइम का वो वीक था तो वो मेरे ख्याल से शुरू का मैंने 10-15 मिनट नहीं सुना होगा
करेक्ट
और फिर उसके बाद आया अच्छा ये तो सुना हुआ लग रहा है ओह सब बत्ती जली है फिल्म
लेकिन आज ये हुआ कि आप हमारा शो जल्दी सुनना शुरू किया आज करेक्ट
आज तो मैंने 5 बजे लगाया मैंने कहा सुबह बोल के गए थे 5 बजे आएंगे देखते हैं 5 बजे आए कि नहीं नहीं चाक लेंगे कड़क जी को बोलेंगे
Exactly. तो आप बताइए आज हम लोग बातें कर रहे हैं टाइमलेस ट्यूजडे मतलब सॉन्ग विच आई थिंक विच यू और आई विल थिंक दैट दे गोना बी टाइमलेस इन द फ्यूचर ये एक्चुअली
आई टोटली एग्री एंड कंफर्म विद द सॉन्ग यू प्लेड और उसी थीम पे मुझे भी एक गाना मुझे जो बहुत अच्छा लगता है आई स्टिल लाइक इट इज इट्स द टाइम टू डिस्को
ओए होए
उसी लाइन पर है बट उसके अलावा अगर मूवी की बात करें, आई लाइक द मूवी जब वी मेट एक्चुअली.
हाँ ओके.
तो वो जो एकदम से बहुत ही सिंपल और वे में बनाई थी मूवी, आई फॉरगॉट हिज नेम.
फज़ानी हेल्प हियर.
Which one? Jo,
Jab we met ka jo director tha, kya naam tha, uska naam bhul gaya.
Who's the director of Jab We Met?
Is that what you're asking me?
I
thought you're asking her.
Yeah, I was asking Faltu Rani, she knows.
But not me, you're not asking me, right? Because I know, she probably, I don't know if she knows.
I don't know if I know. Hey, Jab We Met is
I think it's a story which actually is very interesting. But I think usme gana jo hai that nagara nagara
yaad aati hai.
Kaun sa wala? Kaun sa gana? The slow song. No, but you think
but
that.
Which one are you talking about? The song which
tumse hi.
Well, I gotta give it to him.
Yeah, it's a beautiful song.
Yeah. But you think, I want to ask you sincerely, okay? Do you think this has a sticky DVD? So, matlab, abhi dekho, 2007 mein film aaya tha. You think another
13 years
मतलब मैं पूछने का मतलब ये है कि you think this particular song थोड़ा just you know there's no right or wrong answer to this विशाल जी. तो मैं क्या बोल रहा हूँ कि अगर 2040 में you think the song will still be alive, मतलब will people be listening to the song?
I don't know, I would.
हाँ, that's
I
fine.
Listen, yeah.
नहीं नहीं ऐसे नहीं, I don't know, but you can just say हाँ या ना, doesn't matter. I have
मतलब हाँ, मुझे तो लगता है हाँ है, क्योंकि that's what I think. और
it has a
अपनी राय रख सकता हूँ, but yeah, that's what I think कि सुनेंगे लोग.
Yeah, I think
अच्छा अच्छी lyrics और अच्छा music अभी बहुत कम मिल रहा है ना आज.
Correct.
जब मैंने ट्यून इन किया एंड ये एक्सटेंडेड द रेंज, अगर हम अगर पिछले 4-5 साल या मान लो 6-7 साल की भी बात करें, आई डोंट थिंक देयर वाज एनी सॉन्ग जो हमें 20 साल तो छोड़ो अगले साल भी हम याद करते होंगे, राइट? तो देर माइट बी गिनती के होंगे, बट अभी मेरे को नहीं रहना रहा, तो इसलिए अच्छा हुआ यू एक्सटेंडेड द रेंज कि वो 2000 से लेकर आज तक 20 इयर्स में तो फिर भी बहुत अच्छे गाने आए हैं.
Haan, exactly. So yeah. I think even now, for the matter, people actually who are more familiar with the popular culture now probably will have a different opinion about it than us, right? So we probably are exposed to
generational gap.
Correct. Yeah.
True.
But I think I like It's the Time to Disco is a movie which came out in 2001.
Yeah, that's it. Well, right?
I totally agree with you. That is very nice.
Another Shankar Ehsaan Loy.
Yes.
I mean, all the songs from that movie. In fact, Kal Ho Na Ho, the title track itself, it's almost a haunting, lingering melody.
Correct. Very good. So we got some good entries. Dekho, I think we already identified, starting from Dil Chahta Hai. I think there was some movie before also, but let's start with Dil Chahta Hai because cusp of millennium, right?
Era, I mean, Dil Chahta Hai, Kal Ho Na Ho.
Yeah. And there's one more movie which I will play a song of actually after thing. I'll play a song of your movie which actually has really, I think, has got the kshamata or the capacity to be alive in people's minds for the next 50 years.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
You know which one? Rock On.
Yeah, that's true.
Rock On.
Shola became a cult movie, right?
Yeah.
She's saying it because I like the movie. She was
Hardly
Any
Baar. Holi ka kitna famous song hai.
Exactly. Holi became famous because of that movie.
Ye dosti hum nahi chodenge.
Oh, that's right. That's Sholay. Correct.
What did you think?
I was
wait, let's see what she was. What Sholay?
I thought.
No. What Sholay? What do you think he was?
I thought that Basanti dance. What is that song? That back in kutto ke saamne mat naach. That song. What is that? Jab tak hai jaan.
Jab tak hai jaan.
Just imagine Dharmendra tied up in ropes and all that on the thing. Okay, it's fine. But Vishalji, thank you so much. Aapne do teen entry dal diya hai. Very good. We're going to check back in like 10 years and see if you actually are right.
Yes.
How about that?
Yes. Incha Ganesh, yeah. We'll be on air in 10 years and we'll, you'll also be on air.
10 years ke pehle bhi the aur aage bhi 10 years bhi hoga.
We're going to be on hologram by the way, by the time.
Yeah.
Yes.
Hopefully there'll be no more of this COVID restriction. Let's hope that.
But ha, wo hologram nahi hoga, wo purple tear bhi nahi hoga.
Exactly. Thank you so much for calling us at Sundarega. We have more songs. If we go on more call waiting line, Father, go to them, please.
Namaskar, aapka hardik swagat hai.
Oh, ye kya ho gaya? Jab call karte ho, wait kya karo?
Hardik swagat hai. Pam Pam, main kaun hai ji?
Hello, Pam Pam.
Hello. Kaisi hai, madam?
मैं ठीक हूँ. तुम लोग कहाँ थे कल?
यही पे थे.
आपके दिल में.
आप बस दिल में झांक के दिल देखना
पड़ा. ये गाना लगाना था मुझे.
हाँ लगा दो. हाँ बट दीपा
पैम पैम तक.
हाँ वेरी गुड दीपा. लेकिन पॉइंट पे आओ, भटको मत. बिकॉज विशाल जी ने बताया था, प्रणव जी माई बी लिसनिंग टू अस. प्रणव जी बोलते थे दीपा बहुत भटकाती है. बोलते हैं वेरी गुड. भटकाती है.
हाँ, कुछ भी. अभी मैं एक मिनट भी नहीं हुआ तो पापा बोलते हुए ऐसे इलेक्ट्रिक्ट हो गए आजकल तुम बहुत.
क्या ऐसे क्यों बोलते हो?
कॉल करो अपना जॉब दो और निकलो यहाँ से.
हमारा समय आपके साथ इतना सीमित होता है कि हमें हर क्षण बहुत वैल्यूबल होता है.
Exactly.
तो इसी वजह से हम लोग
एक एक क्षण एक एक वर्ष की.
अच्छा ठीक है बाबा.
हाँ बोल दीपा बताओ ना अभी है. व्हाट इज द थिंग यू शुड टेल मी अबाउट अ टाइमलेस सॉन्ग.
या
I think Beedi Jalaila will be classic.
हाँ interesting. Why do you say it's got to be a classic? Why?
Because it's an item number.
Because it's already a classic. Hai na. Abhi, I think what, 9 years ho gaye usko movie ka ke? No, not 9. My God, more than 9. I think 15 years ho gaye already.
And this is a movie called Omkara, right?
Yes. I think, yes.
Come on,
2005, somewhere around that time, I remember.
So you're saying that this movie will definitely, the song will definitely stay on for some more time, you say?
Yeah. जो अभी तक सी वी कैन जज बेस्ड ऑन दैट जो 10 साल से अभी चल रहे हैं आई थिंक दे विल बी देयर.
Oh that, really?
That is my judgment.
So which
that
song?
One.
You said Beedi Jalaila. You said Beedi Jalaila.
Beedi Jalaila.
Okay.
Yes.
Is there any other song that comes to mind?
क्यों Beedi Jalaila नहीं
चलेगा वो आइटम गान के.
Asking you apart from that, yeah.
Other than that, do you think there's anything else that comes to mind?
Oh, by the way, she's right. Beedi Jalaila came in 2006. Oh my God.
Yeah.
So I was close.
14 years.
Yeah, because. Yeah.
Good. That's. I think it has taken you because story also is like though it's an old story like Othello, right?
That one, yes. And I think even the Sajrale was much before that. I think 2003, 2004.
No, yeah. Bunty or Bubbly? No, it came out in
2005.
Yeah, before that, right? One year before that.
So you're saying that Kajare also is a song which will be sticking along with it?
Yeah, it will stick around.
See, Faldrani, it's not me. Deepa likes it.
Another Shankar Ehsaan Loy. Another Shankar Ehsaan Loy classic.
अरे मैं अभी इसीलिए मैंने Beedi Jalaila बोला. वैसे भी तुम लोग सिर्फ Shankar Ehsaan का बजाते ही हो.
What is this?
इसका मतलब क्या है? गाने अच्छे हैं तो बजाएंगे ना?
नहीं बहुत. There are other songs which are good also.
Hello, madam. We actually have Pritam's song. Jab we met, we have Rock On, which actually is Shankar's song again.
Yeah.
But kaha hai pe dekho timeless classics, man.
I preferred Beedi Jalaila.
Okay,
because you guys said like dance wala number, na?
No, not necessary. You can also have any song.
Then me, us hisab se I would like to listen to this Natum Janana Hariharan song most of the time. Whenever I feel like slow, soft melody, if you don't want to go back in like 70s and all, the Taal movie song.
Oh, that's A.R. Rahman.
90s yeah, mein tha, yeah. Yes, yes.
Yeah, wo 90s mein tha. 90s mein tha.
We'll take it anyways. Mid-90s, is it?
No.
98 or something like that, right?
No, it is 2000.
I think
2000. It was 2000.
Which one? Taal? Impossible.
Yes.
No, man. 2000, I think Anil Kapoor was not a hero or any of those things.
No, man. 1999 or 2000.
99 is what Taal came out, yes.
1999. Yes, 99. I said 99 and then 2000. Yeah.
Okay.
In between that, yes.
So you're saying that Taal... Okay, you know what? Taal music actually...
Yes,
still
Taal
there.
Is one major... which will stay around, like...
Definitely. I can agree with you on
well, that. That way, if you look at it, A.R. Sir's song, one song, which has stood the test of time, it's Chaiya 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 Chaiya. Chale Chaiya 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 Dil Se.
So yeah.
That's still popular. The Jia Jale. Every one of those songs from that movie.
Yeah,
Dil Se
movie.
Very good. So fine. So here's what we'll do, Deepa. Thank you so much for the wonderful entries. You're giving us a couple of entries, and we have Vishalji giving few entries of that.
Yeah.
And if at all 10 years down the line we actually have these songs still in the mindset of people,
yeah,
probably we'll say thank you, Deepa.
And thank you, Vishal.
And you'll win a trip with us to come to Vegas where you can actually bet
with
us.
Yeah, where we can actually go and give an award to each one of these. Who knows? We may be able to.
Aha.
The Dihati Awards.
Yeah.
To the Mahima of Longevity kind of awards to A.R. Rahman, to Shankar Sanlo. You never know, right?
You never know.
Yeah.
People also get the prediction award.
Yeah. So, thank you so much for bringing in, she brought in Vishal Bhardwaj also. That
so
was interesting.
Sweet.
Yeah,
Deepa is always that way. Very nice.
Yeah.
Right, Deepa?
Yes.
Okay, good. So happy she is.
Thank you,
Deepa. Thank you for calling us. Sunte Rahega Panjam. Right now, what we're going to do, we're going to go into a song. And we had to go into a segment as well. So, Falthwani is going to play a nice song, which we think is, how about we play the song Rock On, Falthwani?
Which song from Rock On?
Title track. Or kya yaar? Come on. There's no other song from the movie Rock On which you can play. Rock On number 2 is going to be again going into the dumps for the Jan because it did not do well. Sorry. So Rock On number 2 is not famous, but Rock On 1 will definitely stay in people's minds and probably will be take all the so-called millennials will start saying their parents like this song. And that their parents went crazy on dance floor.
Here you go, Manisha. Suniga, enjoy kijega.
Isi ke saath hum log thoda sa break lagayenge Miljan, and we'll be going into a talk show with Prerna Pal from Palo Alto Medical Foundation, Miljan. Health 360 coming up just a few.
Dil kya kehta hai mera kya main batau? Tum ye samjhoge shayad main pagal hoon. कहता है मेरा क्या मैं बताऊं तुम ये समझोगे शायद मैं पागल हूं दिल करता है टीवी टावर पे मैं चढ़ जाऊं चिल्ला चिल्ला के मैं ये सबसे कह दूं है ये वक्त का इशारा सड़कों पर जोर से गाऊं सब अपने अपने घर की खिड़की खोले फिर मैं ऐसे जोशीले गीत सुनाऊं तेरे गीतों को सुन के सब ये बोले है ये वक्त का इशारा
Jab, we're talking about timeless things, Brajan. Timeless. We're predicting how some of the songs are going to stay on forever and ever. Why? Because they were made well, I suppose, and they're being listened to well as well, Brajan. So right now, the next segment coming up right now, we hope you guys are listening to also quite well, because this next segment is very important for us to be, you know, I think it's very important for everybody to keep in mind. Right, Faldwani?
Well, yes, exactly, Binajan. Abhi aapne wo gana suna. In fact, both the songs that we played today, the lyrical beauty of both the songs is very, very, very high, right? The value of the lyrics. And in this also, he talks about how zindagi milegi na dobara. And he says, enjoy, rock on, ye hai waqt ka ishara, enjoy every moment.
Yes,
kind of thing.
I totally agree with you.
And isi bahane hum log baat karenge aaj with Prerna Uppal from the Palo Alto Medical Foundation, the part of the Sutter Health Group, about emotional health. Kaise usko maintain kare? And how is that connected to weight gain? Let's go on and welcome her. Hi Prerna ji, how are you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you guys?
Wonderful. Thank you so much for asking. It's kind of cold outside, but we are okay. Warm and toasty inside. I know, it's like, you know, I'm kind of very peppy mood because the vaccines are coming. Yay!
Yeah.
I'm happy for everybody on that. Actually.
Yeah, there's a lot more after the vaccine also, Altu Baba. It's not completely going back to the way things used to be.
What?
Anyway, but that is something else altogether. Let's enjoy what we have in the moment. Let's talk to Prerna ji about what she has for our bandhus today.
Well, let's do that.
Yes, so I thought today we'd talk about emotional health and weight gain because you both had brought up this suggestion, brilliant suggestion, because given where we are right now with the new lockdown and holiday stress and basically our modern day life stress, which is always with us, I think it's a really, really good topic to discuss.
Uh-huh.
Yes. And of course, Benjamin, if you have any questions regarding this topic we're talking about, you can give us a call here. The lines are open for you guys to give us a call. 408-912-2479. 408 no ek do do 479. We are Prerna Uppal from Palo Alto Medical Foundation, which now is Sata Health Banajan. And she actually is a nutritionist who also is a yoga practitioner and also dabbles into in a lot of things about Ayurveda and everything. So if you have any questions regarding all these things, how we can actually start if you've never gotten onto a healthy regime or healthy lifestyle, how we can start off, you can give us a call here on 408-912-2479, 408-912-2479.
I remember last, I think the last time you were on, there was a bandhu who said that she's doing everything right except that she's going through major emotional roller coasters and, you know, she's having difficulty in terms of losing belly fat or something like that. Isn't that
exactly?
Yeah,
exactly. I remember that comment, and I think that's when you suggested it's a great topic to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to ask you one thing, if you don't mind. I'm still not able to connect the dots. Emotional health and weight gain. So are you trying to say that if at all we are emotionally not, I would say, not balanced, if we can gain weight? Is that what the whole thing is? Is that the connection?
Yeah, it's a great point. So, yes, emotional well-being is very important for us to even manage our weight, right? I mean, I think the weight loss is way more complicated than the traditional belief of calories in and calories out.
Mm-hmm.
We've always traditionally focused on calories, exercise, and we realize now that there's a lot more going on than meets the eye.
Mm-hmm.
There's stress as well as sleep disturbances, which can also have a big impact on our weight.
Mm-hmm.
And it's true that stress can not only get you to gain weight, but it also makes it harder for you to lose weight, just as our bandhu had made a comment 2 weeks ago.
Right. Right. So, Prerna, is that something that's, what would you call, is this something what we call a psychosomatic thing?
Cool.
Or is there like a relation? I mean, you know, medically, how do you explain it? What is it because of, let me guess, cortisol? Is that because the production of cortisol and the stress hormone that...
Wait, let me see. I think our Google screen is open.
No, it's
you
not.
You must be Googling stuff. Oh my God, what big words and all.
I think you guys have been wonderful sort of viewers all this time. So you picked up a lot from Dr. Sinha and I already.
Yeah.
But it, It is true. So, you know, how does our body respond to stress, right? There's two kinds of stress. There's acute stress and chronic stress.
Okay.
Acute stress is, let's say you and I had an injury and that part of the body gets red and swollen. Your body is actually having a stress response to help heal the injured part. And that is an acute response, which is great because you want that response to be effective. But there's also a chronic stress. And what is that? That is when, you have in the nervous system, you've got the sympathetic nervous system and the parasympathetic nervous system. The sympathetic nervous system is what triggers our stress response. For instance, if I was out on a hike and I saw a mountain lion, my sympathetic nervous system would jump into gear, full gear, because that's my fight and flight response. I'm sure you've heard that. The fight and flight response, that is your sympathetic nervous system preparing you to get away from the stress and the danger. So what happens? Your heart rate goes up, your blood pressure goes up, your blood sugar goes up, so that your muscles have all that they need and your heart has enough capacity to run. All right? Now, when that happens, cortisol, like you mentioned, cortisol levels go up. Cortisol is our stress hormone. It's secreted by the adrenal glands in response to any threat. All right? Now, why this becomes an issue with weight gain and an inability to lose weight is cortisol is an appetite stimulant. So if you and I are constantly in that state of high alert, you know, so you're going to have high levels of cortisol floating around in your system all the time. And cortisol is an appetite stimulant. So it will trigger cravings for comfort foods. Also, what cortisol does, it's a fat storing hormone. So, our bandhu who talked about, I think I've got more fat on my belly. Well, yes, cortisol is definitely responsible for that. It is going and storing more fat, and you end up with more belly fat stores as well.
Wow. And of course, imagine if at all you are in a high stress environment like how I am. What? No, I'm not.
On what basis, Altu Baba? Oh, he's telling me that while you were speaking, he said he is acute stress for me and I'm chronic stress for him. And he says, why acute stress? Because he says he's
I'm
acute
cute guy.
stress stress.
I'm acute stress. And you're like chronic.
Oh,
Yeah.
whatever.
Wait,
Asma, seriously.
That was me.
Thank you. Kabhi kabhi nahi kiya apne energy. So you're saying that stress actually So stress is counterproductive for weight loss. So in other words, if somebody is in a high stress environment and they're trying to do weight loss, you're saying that possibly might not work. Is that the
I think is that emotional stress that you're largely talking about?
Yes. Now, here's what happens. A lot of times I have my women patients who will come in and say that they're not able to lose weight. Now, part of the problem there is that they're so stressed about their inability to lose weight that it perpetuates that stress, right? So you get this loop where you're trying really hard to lose weight, you're not losing weight because you're stressed, and then that stress is not letting you lose weight, and you get into this little cycle. It's important for our bandhus and patients to remember, firstly, we've got to be realistic about weight loss, right? If your mom had, you know, wide hips or carried a lot of weight on her thighs and you're trying to get that skinny figure, you might work pretty hard at it, but the genetics might not quite allow you to have that Barbie doll image you've got in your mind. So I think being very realistic about weight and keeping in mind that what are we trying to do here? We're trying to be healthy, not necessarily look a certain way, might be that sort of determining factor that gets you out of that cycle of the stress loop, right? But it is true that we need to prioritize our emotional health. You've got to say no to things that you know are not serving a purpose in your life. You've got to find ways to cope with things in a more positive way. And there are many strategies for dealing with stress that I do discuss with my patients as well, because we've got to figure out ways to handle those high stress levels.
And of course, we are conversation with Prerna Upper from Palo Alto Medical Foundation, which is right now Sutter Health. And we actually are conversation with her every Tuesday. As you know, we come, alternate Tuesday we have Prerna Ji, and alternate Tuesday we have Dr. Rani Sinha talking to us about our health, what we have to be mindful about and everything. And yes, today we're talking about something very important. Many people actually have noticed this. I have seen many women come back and say, oh, for men it's easy to lose weight.
Huh.
Yeah, but I think it's women is very, very, very difficult to lose stress.
Because like they say in Punjabi, right? Men load ne lete hain. They don't care
oh
a lot of times.
God.
Sorry, I'm just kidding. I'm being very, very,
so
that's a very generic remark.
Oh my God, how can you even say that kind of stuff? No, I'm just kidding. Well, actually, I want to ask you this, Prerna. Prerna, you dabble in yoga. You actually do Ayurveda and everything, and you consult with patients day in and day out. So question to you is, you know, the demography listens to us pretty much as one who comes to you as well, right? The South Asian tech workers or anybody for the matter in this industry or here in the Bay Area.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what are some suggestions you can give? Because knowing the patterns pretty much is similar. Many of them are working from home. Even working from home is extra stress and everything. So what are some strategies which might help? Because you talked about some unhealthy behaviors of, you know, cortisol increasing and all the stuff and tend to eat things. So apart from the fact that you've got to be mindful of eating, knowing what you eat, are there some other behaviors which you can suggest or some modifications people can do in lifestyle to be able to catch the stress thing and, you know, not stress too much? So I think that's my question,
yeah.
I suppose.
Yeah, I just want to clarify, the cortisol part was really the physiological response to stress, right?
Mm-hmm.
It didn't have to do with our habits.
Okay.
It's just the response to the stress.
Okay.
Now, in terms of the unhealthy habits and then what we can do about them,
uh-huh.
One of the things that happens with stress is, like I said, the cortisol will induce or trigger emotional eating and, you know, you want more of those comfort foods. So you want to make sure you're curbing that emotional eating, you know, keep healthy things around the house because out of sight, out of mind, what you have in the house, you are going to use up. Right?
Right.
Okay.
Right.
You also want to make sure you're not compromising on planning because
uh-huh.
when we're stressed, we are so wrapped up in the whole stress problem and that state of mind that cooking a healthy, balanced meal falls by the wayside. I just feel that people want to drive through a fast food place rather than take the time because they don't have the mental energy to focus on fixing something. Right.
Yeah.
People also start exercising less, talking about lifestyle behaviors that change with stress, that, you know, the schedule becomes demanding, you're not as productive because of the stress. So exercise may be one of the last things on your to-do list.
Right.
And now the bandhus at home don't have to put in that much time into commuting.
Uh-huh.
And so I think it's really important to deal with the stress by exercising a little more.
Mm-hmm.
People also skip meals. A lot of my patients will skip meals due to the stress, right? They're juggling so many things that they find that they're either running late for the next meal or they just decide it's too much for them to deal with and they just end up skipping a meal. The one thing that we see a lot is sleeping less. It actually starts impacting your sleep. People struggle with sleep when they're stressed.
Mm-hmm.
And they also don't plan their meals as frequently. They start skipping their workouts. So a lot of downstream effects.
So, Prerna, the bandhu who asked this question is incidentally logged on and said that, how do you deal with... Okay, I think this is something that you definitely need to talk to, see if you can get some help on, but I'll bring it up with you, Prerna, anyway. She says, you're right about the exercise going by the wayside because it's such a struggle to even get out of bed.
Hmm.
It feels like every day is a huge deal. So...
Mm-hmm.
So the person has been exercising, has been eating right, in fact has lost some weight, but is apparently in a situation of chronic stress due to something in the marital environment. So she says, how do you deal with this? I mean, you know, when you have to even literally drag yourself out of bed, you don't feel like getting out of bed. So that's something that you need to speak to a professional, right, Prerna?
Yes, so you know, when we talk about stress for sleep, thanks for sharing, because you know, a lot of people have the same story and they don't always open up. And I firstly don't want this bundle to feel alone, especially now with the lockdown. It has strained so many marriages. I mean, there's newspaper articles being written about how they think the divorce rate is going to go high. So I hope she's not feeling alone. And I think it's really time to reach out to your primary care physician, because with stress, you can either have anxiety or you can start going into depression. And sometimes as it gets worse, you have that lack of inertia. You're not even able to get out of bed. So maybe the doctor referring you to get you a little emotional support, either via counseling or therapy. You know, connect with close friends. Definitely reach out to have those social connections with people that you can trust and share with them what you're going through, so you get that support.
Yeah.
Definitely a good time to reach out to the doctor to maybe start getting therapy assistance.
Absolutely. And I would urge you to please go to the Sutter Health website. Prerna Ji is also, I know that there are some bandhus who have gone to Prerna Ji and Dr. Sinha. You know, they also talk to them about their emotional health as well when they actually go and meet with them as well. I think Alto wanted to add something.
I just want to add one thing here. Everybody listening right now to us, and it is not a bad thing to seek out help. It's not at all a bad thing. I know our culture, we are tuned to say, why we got to keep all the secrets inside a house, what a family. When you're not able to find solutions, when you have to reach out for support, and just because you ask for counseling does not mean anything bad about you, nothing broken about you. It is just that how you find support. When you go to a gym, you have a trainer who's going to train you. Like that, you require somebody who can actually guide you in the whole life process. So don't feel any less that you are reaching out for counseling sessions or even talking to a professional like a psychologist who can actually help you with the whole problems.
And thank you for thinking enough of us to share. I know that you wanted to remain anonymous. So we do hope that you do find peace during this time. And please do not hesitate to reach out to us even. If you think that you want to volunteer, there are opportunities where you can go and serve at several nonprofit organizations as well. It's a sense of giving and a sense of gratitude also. Compassion also helps in dealing with this. So, but like Prerna Ji said, please reach out to your primary care physician. Don't put it off saying, oh, it's not so serious. This is something that you need to take seriously at this particular point in time. So,
I also want to give her some more resources. I don't know if there's any domestic violence issues, but there's domestic violence support groups.
Mm-hmm.
And domestic violence, just because you don't have a bruise and bleed doesn't mean that you're not undergoing abuse. There's a lot of covert narcissistic abuse. So, we need to really empathize with the women who may be stuck in relationships, whether there's financial control, emotional control. And so please reach out to your doctor, find these support groups. Feel free to reach out to me at the clinic or Dr. Sinha, make an appointment with us. We can guide you in the right direction, and we're here for you.
So
please don't feel alone, and feel supported by us.
And yes, if at all you need to connect with them, if you send us a message, we can forward it to them and they can reach out to them as well.
Also, you can go to pamf.org/South Asian or go to Dr. Sinha's blog if you want to write more anonymously. You can actually email him through the blog, southasianhealthsolution.org. Thank you so much, Prerna Ji, for joining us. And we hope to talk to you in a couple of weeks. Till then, stay happy, stay safe, stay healthy. Have a beautiful one.
You too. Thank you so much.
And that's a wrap right here on Health 360 Bandhujan, and also on the Pam Pam Show, I think.
That's right. Yep.
And we will be playing some beautiful music for you in the next hour. We'll be back tomorrow right here on Good Morning Bay. Till then, have yourselves a fantastic, safe, healthy, happy time.
Radio D Hotties, powered by Mahima Creations.
The views and opinions.